Hey guys, it's Memorizer92, and today I'm gonna cover Pinnacle Spec Swift 4.3 build that I theory crafted. I'm trying to switch over when the tripod patch happens in KR server. Then, let's get started. Well, this build is slightly different from typical Spec Swift 4.3 build. I believe there might be some people who are already using the same build. Let me explain step by step. The gear you want to use for this build is Salvation Set, not Nightmare. Let me tell you the reason later. Stat is Spec and Swiftness. Now, the most important part, the skill set. I will quickly show you what skills and tripods I use and explain the important parts. Half Moonslash, Conviction Rune, Raging Dragon Slash, Gale Wing, Wheel of Blade, Judgment, Shackling Blue Dragon, Bleed Rune, Four-Headed Dragon, Gale Wing, Thrust of Destruction, Gale Wing as well, and finally Red Dragon Horn, Gale Wing as well. Okay, now let me go over the ones that need explanation. First of all, this build use Four-Headed Dragon over Starfall Pounce. The pros of Starfall Pounce is it always crits, but the cons is it has low damage dealing. On the other hand, Four-Head Dragon doesn't guarantee crits but has higher ceiling if you have good level on the tripods. Vital Point Hit gives you 40% crit rate, and Violent Thrust gives 20% crit rate, which is 60% in total. If you back attack, that's 70%. Let me try to compare damage between Starfall Pounce and Four-Headed Dragon. Well, Starfall Pounce, you want to use these tripod as Spec Swift, all level 5, Four-Headed Dragon all level 5 as well, their skill level is 12, and I'm using the same level 8 gem, Starfall Pounce and Four-Headed Dragon. So, to measure the damage of Four-Headed Dragon correctly, I will switch over to Blue Stance right away after using Four-Headed Dragon, since that's how people make the bleed damage crit. So let's use the Starfall Pounce first. So that did around 15 million damage. This time, let me try to use Four-Headed Dragon. You can see that it has higher potential when it's backed up with crit rate. As you can see, all three red skills are either holding skill or charging skills, which is why I'm gonna run Salvation Set since it gives you 10% more attack speed. And the reason why I'm using Wheel of Blades over Chain Slash or Stampeding Slash is because, first of all, they all do similar damage. But Will of Blaze have push immunity, so it's easy to land the skills. Second of all, it does lots of hits, so it's easy to activate Judgment. Lastly, Tornado on Half Moon Slash and Precise Slash on Raging Dragon Slash. Reason for Tornado, which is weaker than the Chasing Slash, is because I'm using Weak Point Detection on the Thrust of Destruction. For more potential. To make this potential come true, I need to land Thrust of Destruction before the Shackling Blue Dragon's crit buff ends. If I use Chasing Slash on the Half Moon Slash, then it will be really tight to land Thrust of Destruction in time before the crit buff ends. Let me show you this. The duration time of Shackling Blue Dragon is 6 seconds. You can see beneath the HP bar if I use it like this. Well, first, let me use the Chasing Slash tripod. Here I go. Well, as you can see, Thrust of Destruction lands in time, but when around 1 second is left, which means it will be super tight in the real raid. This time, let's try Tornado Slash. What? Well, as you can see, it lands when around 2 seconds are left, which is why I would recommend for the Tornado Slash. Well, still, I do lose lots of DPS if I run Tornado over Chasing Slash, because this one increases 80% damage at level 5, and this one increases 120% at level 5. To compensate this, I'm running Precise Slash on Raging Dragon Slash, which does a lot more damage compared to any of the two tripods. The problem of this tripod is the long animation, but this is why you want to put Gilewing rune in this skill. Engraving is common for 4-3 build. Grudge, King Lung Weapon, Cursed Doll, Raid Captain, Pinnacle, and 1 level 1 Adrenaline. Well, you can ignore the Adrenaline since having additional level 1 engraving in the West is only viable if you have 9-7 stone. Other than these engravings, there might be 3 other engravings that you might raise up: Mass Increase, Ambush Master, and All Out Attack. Well, Mass Increase did similar DPS with Raid Captain, which means you wanna run Raid Captain since it doesn't have 10% attack speed penalty. This is for 4-3, not 5-2. You wanna run Mass Increase on the 5-2. Okay, and next one, Ambush Master. Well, Ambush Master has higher potential than any other engravings, but you will lose tons of DPS when you fail the back attack. Also, Earth and Trophy Set is the one that matches Ambush Master. Lastly, All Out Attack only benefits 4 skills. Well, Red Dragon Horn, Four-Headed Dragon, and the Half Moon Slash if you run the Chasing Slash, and the second Awakening. Well, even Raid Captain benefits blue skills because of the swiftness stat that I have as a substat, and also the movement speed buff from the Swamp of Yearning set that support has. And not only that, Salvation set gives you 10% attack speed, which means you don't need the additional attack speed boost from All Out Attack as well. For the gems, you wanna run attack gems on all 6 DPS skills: Raging Dragon Slash, Half Moon Slash, Thrust of Destruction, Wheel of Blade, Red Dragon Horn, and Four-Headed Dragon. And for the rest of the 5 gems, you wanna run Cooldown Reduction Gem on Half Moon Slash, and Thrust of Destruction, Shackling Blue Dragon, Red Dragon Horn, and Raging Dragon Slash. For the card set, Salvation set is the best. If you do not have it, then plus 12 Lost Windcliff is the semi-best one. And if you even don't have that, then anything is fine. Now, let me show you the rough rotation. Raging Dragon Slash is the one you wanna open before Shackling Blue Dragon, since the third tripod of Raging Dragon Slash already increases 25% crit rate. Then you wanna use Shackling Blue Dragon and activate Conviction and Judgment by using Half Moon Slash and Wheel of Blade combo, and immediately land Thrust of Destruction before the buff, the Shackling Blue Dragon buff ends. And then use Red Dragon Horn and Four-Headed Dragon and switch back to blue stance for the better bleed damage. If the blue skills are in cooldown in the rotation, it's okay. Just use other level 1 blue skills before the ones that you mastered comes back. Well guys, that's all for today. Thanks for watching, and hit the sub if you guys liked it. Then see you guys on next video. Bye bye.